We've heard of criminals stealing copper from freeway lights, but now we're hearing of thieves going straight to the source and ripping off suppliers and contractors. We wanted to know why they continue to steal when there is a law to prevent it. Christina Weno got the answers. Chris?
Kathy, people continue to steal copper because there's still a market for it. And we have the video that shows how criminals are doing it.
This is what a surveillance camera at Jack Endo Electric caught last month. A criminal whose face is covered with a t-shirt going through the company's warehouse, unspooling valuable copper. And then later, you see a partner in crime.
What kind of problem have you had with copper theft?
Well, in the recent months, we probably lost retail value of over $10,000 worth of copper.
Steve Endo says his family's business has been ripped off numerous times.
We didn't have a camera in our warehouse before, but we put in a, that's why we spent more money to get a better camera, but it didn't deter them.
It didn't deter them, just caught them in the act. You can see in this video, taken from a different camera, the criminal dragging the copper outside the warehouse, a warehouse that was locked behind a fence.
They have the means to cut a metal warehouse in order to enter, and they climb over the walls.
This isn't the only company that's been ripped off.
So you've been hit as well?
I talked to three other electrical contractors who have also been victims of copper theft. So why is the crime continuing despite a law that's been on the books for 4 years? Police say it's because thieves are possibly selling it to people who are willing to buy it. The law says anyone who wants to sell copper needs to show an ID and notarized paperwork proving it wasn't stolen. The recycling company takes the seller's picture, and Honolulu police will work with companies to confirm information. But some recycling companies say not everyone is following the law. In fact, the number of people charged with copper theft on Oahu is increasing. Honolulu prosecutors charged 5 people with the crime in the fiscal year 2011, 7 people in 2012, and 10 people in 2013. As for Endo, he hopes the criminals in this video will also be caught. He's already spent and lost thousands of dollars to this crime.
But all those small things eat into our costs where we have a hard time paying small vendors because the money went to that instead, and you know, it's a vicious cycle.
In addition to surveillance cameras and good lighting, HPD says people can also protect their property by installing an alarm and motion sensor lights. Christina Ueno, KHON2 News.